Hello everyone. So in previous part, that is part 1 of nucleophilic addition to CC multiple bond, we had the preliminary idea of about this reaction. Okay, that is what is nucleophilic addition to CC multiple bond. And we have also seen that this type of reaction, that is addition of nucleophile to alkene, it is not very common. Okay, now what is the reason behind? There is repulsion between the electron density of nucleophile and the pi electron cloud of alkene. So when there is some electron withdrawing group present, then this type of nucleophilic addition is possible, because electron withdrawing group, it reduces the electron density of CC multiple bond. So similarly, here we have addition to CC double bond attached to CO double bond. So CO double bond, here it will act as electron withdrawing group which is attached to CC. As a result, nucleophilic addition to CC bond, that is possible. Okay, so here we have the resonance structures of CC double bond which is attached to CO double bond. Now you can call it as alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, because with respect to carbonyl, this is alpha beta unsaturated compound, that is unsaturated CC double bond, and this is also known as enone. Enone means in, which is CC double bond, and on means CO double bond. So together it will be called as enone. Fine. So here, if we break one of these bond, this is alpha, this is beta, then we can write positive charge on this carbon, negative charge on this oxygen, and after resonance, that is if this CC double bond, if it is shifted to the carbon which is attached to CO, now the positive charge is at this carbon. So here we will number the positions. This is 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can see positive charge is present at 2 carbon and at 4 carbon. So nucleophile, it can attack at 2 carbon and it can also attack at 4 carbon. Fine. So here it is written that conjugation of the double bond to a carbonyl group, what it does, it transmits the electrophilic character of the carbonyl carbon. That is, this carbon is electrophilic because it is the carbon of the carbonyl group. So now this electrophilic character, because of resonance, it will be transmitted to the 4 carbon, that is the beta carbon of the double bond. This is 4 carbon, we can also call it beta carbon. And these conjugated carbonyl, they are known as enone or alpha beta unsaturated carbonyls. So now the nucleophile, it has two possibilities. It can attack 4 carbon or it can attack 2 carbon. Depending on that, two types of addition is possible. So CO group can itself undergo nucleophilic attack. So when it is attacked at 2 carbon, then it will be called as 1-2 addition or addition to CO. That is the net addition of nucleophile and H to 1 and 2 position. This is 1, this is 2. And if the attack is at 4 carbon, then it is 1-4 addition. It can also be called as conjugate addition because it is involving some conjugation, or it is addition to CC double bond. Now at a first glance, if we number it 1, 2, 3, 4, it seems that is the net addition of H and NU, that is at 3 and 4 position. Then why we are calling it 1-4 addition? Because addition is not at 1-4. But actually, if you see the detailed mechanism, you will understand that first the addition is at oxygen, that is 1 position and 4 position. That is this hydrogen, first it is at 1 oxygen and then it is transferred to carbon number 3. So basically it is 1-4 addition, but after, that is hydrogen, it will be shifted from this 1 oxygen to this 3 carbon. So ultimately it seems as if it is 3-4 addition, but actually it is 1-4 addition. So it is addition to CC double bond, as if it is 3-4 addition, but actually from the mechanism it is 1-4 addition. So let's see the mechanism. First, nucleophilic attack on the carbon which is beta with respect to carbonyl, that is 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. We can also write beta and alpha. So the nucleophile, it will attack at this carbon and double bond will be shifted. There will be negative charge over oxygen. Next, there is proton transfer. So the proton which is attached to nucleophile, it will be shifted to this carbon. Now there is OH and nucleophile. So here you can understand why it is 1,4 addition, because this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So net addition, that is H and NU at 1 and 4. So that is why it is 1,4 addition. And finally, there is tautomerization. So from one position, now the hydrogen, it will be shifted to 3 position. Okay. So this type of oxygen hydrogen bond will be broken. CC double bond will be broken. There will be negative charge over 3 carbon and the proton will be shifted. So this is actually tautomerization. From enol form, it is converted to keto form. Keto-enol tautomerization. So this is the mechanism of 1,4 addition. We will see some examples of 1,4 addition. But before that, we have to know that when we will be getting 1,2 addition and when we will be getting 1,4 addition. What are the factors on which it depends? So it depends on whether the reaction is reversible or not. So if it is reversible, then it will be 1,4 addition. If it is irreversible, it will be 1,2 addition. And if we know the nature of the nucleophile, depending on that also, 1,2 versus 1,4 mechanism can take place. So if the nucleophile is weak, weak nucleophile means it is less, more stable and less reactive. Examples, alcohol, amine, etc. So here, reaction will be reversible. And if the nucleophile is strong, strong means it will be more reactive and less unstable. So examples are Grignard, metal hydride, for example, lithium aluminium hydride or sodium borohydride. So if we are using this type of strong nucleophile, reaction will be irreversible. So when it is reversible, basically there is control of product thermodynamic. That means we will get thermodynamic product by 1,4 addition. So when it is 1,4 addition, basically we are getting A. And in 1,4 addition, CO group is intact. And if it is 1,2 addition, now CC bond is intact. Now CO double bond, that is more strong compared to CC double bond. So that is the reason that it is thermodynamically more stable. That is A. This is CC adduct. CC adduct means when addition is taking place at CC double bond. Z and H, it is added at CC double bond. In that case, CO double bond will remain intact. So in CC adduct, that is A, it is thermodynamically more stable compared to CO adduct. CO adduct means B. CO adduct, there is addition of H and Z at oxygen and carbon, that is 1 and 2. And this is 4 and 1. But after tautomerization, hydrogen will be shifted to 3 carbon. Fine. So this is the reason why CC adduct is thermodynamically more stable, because CO bond is present. But in CO adduct, that is B, CC bond is intact, which is less stable. So that is why, not less stable, I mean, which is less strong compared to CO double bond. So that is why it is not thermodynamic product. Fine. And another point is, if there is steric hindrance at any of the site, suppose there is steric hindrance at R group, obviously in that case nucleophile will prefer to attack at 4 carbon. And if there is steric hindrance at the left hand side, that is at 4 carbon, then nucleophile, it will prefer to attack at carbonyl carbon. Okay. So here we have some examples. Examples of 1,4 addition, all are reversible. So here our nucleophile is Rn to N minus, Rs minus, RO minus and CN minus. So all are very weak nucleophile. That means they are more stable and less reactive. So here in all cases we are getting 1,4 addition. And we have already seen the mechanism that first the this hydrogen it was first at this oxygen, and after tautomerization it is shifted from oxygen to carbon. Next we will see some examples of 1-2 addition. So here our nucleophile is R minus, because this is a negative part, this is a positive part, okay, and we have R minus also here. And in case of lithium aluminium hydride, that is metal hydride and sodium borohydride, here nucleophile is H minus. So basically two hydrogen will be added to CO. One is added to oxygen, which is 1, which is 2, and the second hydrogen added to 2 carbon. And here R minus, it will attack carbonyl carbon. So H and R, this is 1, this is 2, this is 1, this is 2. So addition of, net addition of R and H, and this H is coming from H3O plus in both cases. So here in case of hydride, H next, and that is the another hydrogen that will come from H3O plus, and in case of sodium borohydride we are using methanol, which will give one of the proton. Okay, here we have a problem. Suggest two possible pairs of starting materials for the synthesis of this compound, and which one of them will be preferred. So suppose we are breaking the molecule at this point, so in that case what we will get? PHCO, PH positive charge here and negative charge. It will be preferred here because two electron withdrawing group is present. And this we can write as PHCO CC double bond PH, and this one will be diethyl malonate. And another option is there, if we break the bond at this position. So now what we are getting? PH COCH2- and PH CH2+ CO2. Now we can write it as PH COCH3. So this is one reaction partner, and from this PH CC double bond COOET, I am writing CO2ET in extended way. Why, you will understand after some time. Okay, so here if we compare the two nucleophile, we will be able to understand which one is weaker and which one is stronger nucleophile. So this nucleophile is basically stronger nucleophile, PHCOCH2-, and which one is weaker nucleophile? This one is weaker nucleophile, weak nucleophile, and this is strong nucleophile. Okay, so strong nucleophile means it will be less stable and it will be very reactive. So as it is very reactive, it will attack the carbonyl carbon. So this negative charge, it will be attacking PHCOCH2-, it will attack at this carbon. Okay, so this is actually carbonyl carbon. You can also consider it 1-2 addition because it is 1, 2, 3 and 4. So here we are not getting our expected product. So that is why this pathway, it is not correct. But if it is weaker nucleophile, that is the nucleophile that we are getting from diethyl malonate. So that nucleophile, as it is weaker and as it is more stable, that means less reactive, so it will attack the at 4 position, CO2ET. Basically here we will require some base that will remove this proton of this CH2, and there will be negative charge generation. This negative charge, it will attack here, oxygen, it will be O-, and it will take proton from the protonated base. So we will get PH, I am jumping the step and writing directly OH, pH. CO2 ET, and next what will happen? Sorry, there is CC double bond. This COOH bond will be broken and there will be negative charge on carbon, and finally we will get PHCO, that is our expected product, CH2 PH, CO2 ET CO2. So here this pathway is correct, but this pathway it is not correct. And remember, this reaction, that is the reaction which is on the left hand side, this is actually Michael reaction that will be discussed in the next slide. Okay, it will be discussed in the, sorry, not next slide, in the next video I will discuss it, because this Michael reaction, this is the most important reaction under nucleophilic addition to CC multiple bond. It is a name reaction. And there we will see the full mechanism of this reaction, okay, and also why it is important, some application of Michael reaction, all this will be discussed in the next video. So until then, goodbye. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe. You will get all the important links in the description box, and thank you for your time.